Hello everyone, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So today again I'm going to take up questions that are relevant for your upcoming NABARD grade A and B examination, as well as the questions that I take are also important for your RBI and SEBI exams. Okay, so let's begin today's video. But before that, if you haven't subscribed our channel, then do subscribe and hit the bell notification, guys. And you can also join this Telegram group where you will get the PDF of this session. The link of this group is in description below. Guys, the very first news that we are going to discuss here is this Gramin Krishi Mausam Seva scheme. First of all, this scheme is not at all a new scheme. This was launched in 2017 only. Then why is it in the news? Because recently the Minister of Earth Sciences, Dr. Jitendra Singh, Minister of Science and Technology and Earth Sciences, has informed Rajya Sabha that 200 agro-automatic weather stations will be installed at district agromat units which are located in the Krishi Vigyan Kendras under the Gramin Krishi Mausam Seva scheme. So basically the first news that we have, the current news that we have, is that 200 agro automatic weather units will be established at these district agromat units that are located at the Krishi Vigyan Kendras under the scheme which is named as Gramin Krishi Mausam Seva scheme. Now what is the whole purpose of this scheme? That we will be discussing, but let's first know the purpose of this agro automatic weather station. Naam se hi pata chal raha hai. This is a weather station, so this looks something like this. So this creates or this captures the information related to the weather patterns, and on the basis of the information gathered through these agro automatic weather stations, these district agromat units communicate the information further to the farmers or to the state agriculture departments so that they can form advisories, agricultural advisories. Basically, agricultural advisories are formed at the level of district agromat units only. They have got the information that at this area there would be a flood. Okay, for example, Vishakhapatnam, there would be a flood. So they have got this area through this information through this weather station or agro automatic weather station. Now, this district agromat unit, which is established at every district, this unit at the KVK will form the advisories, agromat advisories, that what kind of actions should the farmers take in order to mitigate the impact of flood, and what kind of actions should the state agriculture department take in order to mitigate the impact on agriculture. Remember that the services of this weather station is used for mitigating the impact on agriculture, agromat advisories. So if you break this word, so MET stands for meteorology, agro for agriculture, so the meteorology service advice for agriculture. Okay, so I hope that this much is clear to you. Now let's move on to the scheme, because this scheme is very much related to this agro met advisory service, or we can say the crux of the scheme is this only, agro met advisory services. Now let's move on to the scheme. So as I told you that this scheme was launched in 2017. Achha, the one thing that I forgot to tell you previously is the type of question that can be made out of this news. So the type of question, direct question can be made from this, that how many agro automatic weather stations will be established. The next question is that IMD is going to establish these weather stations. So which organization is going to establish these weather stations? Then the answer would be IMD. Where are these district agromat units are located? So they are located at Krishi Vigyan Kendras. Under which scheme will IMD establish 200 agro automatic weather stations? Then the answer would be Gramin Kisan Mausam Seva scheme. So all these questions are coming up from this news only. I hope that you have noted down the questions so that you can just prepare this news accordingly. Now let's discuss the scheme. 2017 mein this was launched by the Ministry of Earth Sciences. This scheme is administered by Indian Meteorological Department and Indian Council of Agriculture Research and State Agricultural Universities. The scheme provides advisories for weather-based crop and livestock management. Clear? Under the scheme, medium range weather forecast at district and block level is generated, and based on the forecast, AgroMet advisories are prepared. So as I informed you earlier as well, AgroMet advisories that are based on the meteorological data, weather data that are relevant for agriculture, so that the impact of climate change and calamities can be reduced on agriculture. Okay, so these advisories are prepared and communicated to the farmers on every Tuesday and Wednesday. So certain days are fixed on which the advisories are communicated. The advisories are communicated by AgroMet field units. So who communicates the advisories to the farmers? AgroMet field units, which are located in state agricultural universities, and district AgroMet units that are located at Krishi Vikas Kendras. So these advisories are given to farmers by these two units, AgroMet field units and district AgroMet units. These AgroMet advisories help farmers to take informed decisions related to their day-to-day agriculture operations to reduce monetary loss and maximize crop yield during deficient rainfall situation and extreme weather events. So I hope that there is no need for understanding here, there is no need for discussion here, because this is very easy to understand. When the rainfall is going to be deficient and you are aware about it in advance, then obviously you will cut down on your cost, you will cut down on your expenses and try to yield, try to gain the maximum yield from the crops. Similarly, you will do the opposite in the situation of extreme weather events. IMD monitors the rainfall and weather situations and issues alerts to farmers and state departments of agriculture for effective management of calamity. So again, we are talking about the agriculture in order to mitigate and reduce the impact of the calamity on agriculture. This scheme is launched. These alerts are sent through various modes like print and electronic media, Doordarshan, radio, internet, etc. SMS se bhi bheje jaate hain, SMS using mobile phone through Kisan portal. Ministry of Earth Science had also launched an application named Meghdoot, which provides advisories to the farmers related to weather. So that's all about this Gramin Krishi Mausam Seva scheme. I hope that you have understood the scheme thoroughly. You have understood what the agro automatic weather stations are. They collect the weather information and they provide the data collected to the units, the district AgroMet units that are located at KVKs. Okay, and then they form the advisories, the AgroMet advisories, and then they communicate it to the farmers and state agriculture departments. So that's all for this scheme. Now we are moving on to the first question of the day. Which state is providing ₹6,000 annually to the 12 lakh landless labor families in the state to help them in accessing basic amenities? Jharkhand, Bihar, Chhattisgarh, Tripura, Kerala. So Chhattisgarh is the right answer. The name of this scheme is Rajiv Gandhi Bhumihin Mazdoor न्याय योजना. राजीव गांधी भूमिहीन मजदूर न्याय योजना. ठीक है, दिस इज द नेम ऑफ द स्कीम अंडर विच ₹6,000 विल बी गिवन टू द लैंडलेस लेबर फैमिलीज इन द स्टेट. ऑल्सो रिमेंबर दैट द वर्कर्स कवरिंग अंडर द MGNREGA स्कीम आर ऑल्सो बींग कवर्ड अंडर दिस योजना. Now the total budget of this scheme is ₹200 crores. So do remember this amount that is given to the landless laborers in this scheme, Rajiv Gandhi Bhumihin Mazdoor Nyay Yojana. Next question is, which state has launched the doorstep healthcare scheme? So this scheme has been launched by Tamil Nadu government, and the purpose is to stop the people who are having non-communicable diseases from visiting hospital, because this is the duration of COVID pandemic and there are high chances that they might contact with the COVID-19 infected patients. Therefore, in order to protect their health only, this scheme has been launched so that services, healthcare services will be provided to the people who are suffering from non-communicable diseases at their doorstep. That is the whole purpose, which is very evident from the name itself. But do remember that it is for the non-communicable diseases patients. With which bank has National Fisheries Development Board signed an MOU to extend financial assistance to the fisheries sector through the bank? So all the bank branches as well as the banking correspondents of this bank will help the will provide the credit to the fisheries sector, to the fisheries project that are identified by National Fisheries Development Board. So which bank is this? This is Punjab National Bank. Which of the following countries is the new entrant in the Coalition for Disaster Resilience Infrastructure? Canada, Bangladesh, Philippines are in the options, out of which both Canada and Bangladesh, that is option both A and B, is the right answer. So these two have recently joined the Coalition for Disaster Resilient Infrastructure. Now there are 25 members and 7 organizations, 25 countries and 7 organizations that are members of this treaty, of this Coalition for Disaster Resilient Infrastructure. Guys, here I would like to inform you all that yesterday only I took a session on treaties and conventions. And if you haven't seen that session yet, then go and watch that session after completing this session, because that session was very helpful for your preparation of NABARD grade A and B examination. Okay. Now, as far as this Coalition for Disaster Resilient Infrastructure is concerned, so it was launched in 2019 by the Prime Minister of India, and this conducts international conference. On disaster resilient infrastructure. So International Conference on Disaster Resilience Infrastructure. This is conducted annually by the CDRI, and this year too it was conducted in the month of March. However, the version was virtual. So this conference was virtual in the month of March. So do remember, it is the annual conference conducted by CDRI, and the purpose is to give a platform for all the members so that they can share their experiences and research on the collaborate on researching on the resilient infrastructure technologies. Okay. Which UT has launched Pani Mah to raise awareness about clean water and to accelerate the implementation of Jal Jeevan Mission in the Union Territory? Ladakh, Jammu Kashmir, Puducherry, Delhi, Andaman and Nicobar are in the options, out of which Ladakh is the right answer. Now from the question itself, it is clear what the administration of Ladakh is going to do under this Pani Maha, that is Pani Month, Water Month. Okay. Now, the purpose here is to accelerate the implementation of Jal Jeevan Mission, and in order to speed up the implementation, the administration has announced some rewards for villages as well as blocks. So the reward is rupees 5 lakh for the first 5 villages of every district in the state will be given. This amount will be given to the first 5 villages who will have Har Ghar Jal facility, basically who will achieve the water supply, who will provide the water supply to every household in the village, water supply through tap. Okay. The next reward is for blocks. So 25 lakh reward will be given to one block in one district for achieving the target of Har Ghar Jal, that is providing water facility to every household in the block. Remember, 25 lakh, one block, one district, 5 lakh, five villages, first five villages of every district. Okay, so that's all about this Pani Ma and for today's video. Thank you so much guys for watching the video. Very, very good luck for your preparation.